And settle down. Children too, we'll continue painting after the end of the event. Are merely actors.
Duniya ek rang ban che aur sabhi kirdaar nibhate hain aur sabhi milkar koi na koi kahani banate hain. Kya hum sabhi yahan koi kahani banane aaye hain?
Yes, we definitely are. But before that, let me take this opportunity and say, ladies and gentlemen, and the bachcha party,
swagat hai aap sabhi ka.
On behalf of the entire Red Bricks team, we welcome you all to the closing ceremony of Kathotsav.
Milanjan, tum kuch kahani sunane wale the?
Well, here I go. Once upon a time, in the land of Ahmedabad, there was held a Kathotsav.
Aur phir?
Well, Kathotsav began on the 24th of January with kids coming, underprivileged kids coming in for a splendid performance by a Maika troupe. Then it began on the 26th of January at Sundarban, where we celebrated Republic Day and the first performance by Kathalaya. And then after this, let's hear more about Kathotsav from the founder of Red Bricks, Mrs. Ranita Handa. I would like to welcome her on stage.
Balloons, white balloons, because it was Republic Day. But today we come to the end of the story. This is the last event of Kathotsav, but as I also told on the first day, I hope that we keep on celebrating stories in our homes even after this festival. Today I want to reflect on a couple of things. First, when we thought of the idea of Kathotsav for Ahmedabad, we were thinking that will people be really interested in a story festival? Will it really generate that interest in children, parents and educators? And trust me, in 3 days we had all the workshops were full and we were very excited and very happy to learn that today's parents and today's teachers are also willing to experiment with new techniques of teaching and learning. In a way, stories have been an age-old tradition, but somehow in today's academic world, we have forgotten that stories are such powerful educational tools. At Red Bricks, we believe that learning happens by experiencing, and in 3 days, we have experienced stories in its full emotions along with the Kathalaya facilitators. From this festival, my expectation was that by the end of the festival, I might become an expert storyteller like Geeta ji. But today morning, I attended her workshop, which was for teachers and parents, and it changed my mind. Because the message that she gave was, there is a storyteller in each one of us. Each one of us has our own strengths. We may not be the best voice modulators, or may not have the best body language. But each of us has a strength and we need to find what is our strength to become the best storyteller. So thank you so much, Geeta ji, Shreya and Bhuvana, to come from Bangalore and share your stories and expertise with us. And we look forward to your performances today. Before that, we will also have kids and adults who were a part of the workshops yesterday performing their own self-created stories. So let us also encourage them, because they have not prepared a lot, but they will, I'm sure, perform wonderfully today. Thank you. And I would like to invite Geeta ji to now speak a few words. Encouraging, and we've had a wonderful set of children. Your children are marvelous. They say, no, your children are our children, right? So I could really feel that they were our children. And I kept telling Venita that this is one place that I will never hesitate, will never say no if you call me again. Yes, it's been wonderful. And I must thank all of you, parents who are seated here, to trust and to believe that this is a one beautiful institution. Very few people encourage storytelling and storytellers like us. So I'm very privileged to be here. I thank her a lot for this, and it's been a wonderful, wonderful journey. To just start off, I just thought I will share a small story with you. Shall I? Yes. Okay. Once upon a time, there was a storyteller. And this storyteller went from one land to another land telling stories. Now, you know how storytellers are, right? And they use their voice. They use their body language. That's how traditional storytellers are. So this storyteller also used a lot of his voice. Ha 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 ha. And he told stories of this and that and that and this. And he made screeching sounds. He made big sounds. He made small sounds. And then, at the end of the storytelling, he was feeling very, very tired. And very good. Who's that? He was feeling very fantastic. He was feeling very hungry. You know, Indians, we always feel hungry. In Ahmedabad, we've been only eating and eating. So now this storyteller felt very hungry. Now he comes to a house, and like in Ahmedabad, people are very hospitable. So he knocks on the door. Now a lady opens the door and she says, come in, come in, come in. Ow, ow, ow. And then sit down. And yesterday we went to Vishala. Apu, Apu, they kept on saying. So now this man sat down to eat. And that lady said, Apu, Apu. And then he ate and ate and ate. But when he was about to eat, there was another knock. And then there was somebody who went, opened the door and tap, closed the door. Now this man, the storyteller, was wondering, who is this person? But he was too hungry, so he ate. And then he went, he told more stories. In those days, no electricity, you know. So in the evening, they would finish the job and go to sleep. He went to another house after another session of storytelling. Again somebody opened. And then he ate, and just as he was about to eat the tepla, was a knock. Tuck, 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 tuck. And again, tuck. The person in that house closed the door. He was wondering, who's this coming behind me? Now he finished eating, came out. And then he went near a lovely tree like this. Lovely evening time. Yes? Now he had only one big cloak. No, they don't wear. Storytellers are not too rich. Even today, they're not very rich. So they're more wanderers. No? So he had one cloak. So, and he put it. He was about to sleep. And he heard somebody crying. And behind the tree, there was a shadow. So he went, and there was a small girl like her. Little girl. And she said, from today morning, I was coming behind. Oh, so you were coming. I'm very hungry. He said, wait, 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 wait. Now that tree had a lot of fruits. She climbed the tree, gave her some fruits, and she ate. Because she was so hungry. After eating,
He said, now you go to sleep, we'll discuss everything tomorrow morning. So she went to sleep. Next day morning, nicely took a bath in the river. She was ready, he was also ready. Now he said, okay, hold my finger. You come with me. Why do you want to come behind me? You come along with me. So when they were walking, he said, Hare, maine to aapka naam hi nahi pucha. What's your name? She said, my name is Truth. He said, what? My name is Truth. Ah, that's why people bang the door on your face. Huh? So from now on, you don't have to come behind me. You come along with me. So they say that wherever the storyteller goes, the truth always goes along with the storyteller. Yes? So with this truth, I'm hoping that we will have the end of the festival also in a grand way. I want to thank once more Renita and all her colleagues, her husband and the whole family for inviting us. And thanks to all of you for being such a wonderful audience. Thank you.
Your words of wisdom, and thank you, Renita ma'am, for your reflections, wonderful reflections. Now, to relive the moments of Kathotsava which we have been having, let's call on stage two little creative geniuses who will bring before you the magical world of imagination of the child's mind.
चलिए बुलाते हैं स्टेज पर सुहासी को जो प्रस्तुत करेगी नहीं मैं नहीं बताऊंगी खुद सुहासी बताएगी
A Japanese story. The title of my story is When the Sun Ran Away. Once upon a time, the god in